usually at some point.
We go down one, three, three, repeat back to the beginning.
Yep.
And on the next repeat, we just keep going back to the beginning.
Yeah.
And where does that end?
We ignore from G on out.
Oh, okay. So once we get to the one to G.
Yeah. Gotcha.
Okay.
Nice.
What are we doing?
First time through the whole thing is the whole piece. Once you get to the end, VS to A. When you get to that first ending that says 2G, it's 2A. And we're going to repeat that block over and over again.
Okay.
Until she cuts us. Yep.
Yes,
so just one time through the whole thing.
Yeah, only one time.
Yes, yes.
Ready? One, two, ready.
Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Gracious God, we ask your blessing on our ceremonies this afternoon and upon all gathered here, especially the parents and families of those who will graduate today. We ask a particular blessing on the men and women of the class of 2016. Guided by your providence, they came here a few short years ago, seeking knowledge and understanding. Allow them to see that life and wisdom and all good things come to us through you. You have blessed their days here with friendships that will be among their most cherished possessions all the days of their lives. May they always be the best of friends, wanting only what is good and right for one another. You have blessed them with professors who led them in their search for truth and wisdom. May they hold dear what they have learned, and may it lead them to lives of service so that they themselves become a blessing to all who encounter them. May they hunger for justice and satisfy that hunger by using their time and talents on behalf of those in need. You have blessed them with a love of Saint Anselm College. Bring them back here often to remember and rejoice in their time spent on this hilltop. Bless them now and always. Protect them, watch over them all the days of their lives. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Please remain standing and join in the singing of the national anthem led by the senior members of the college choir. Please be seated. The student speaker chosen to address us in the name of the class of 2016 is Christine Adams, an international relations and Spanish major from Alton, New Hampshire.
President DiSalvo, Abbot Mark, the Benedictine community, members of the Board of Trustees, honorary degree recipients, beloved faculty and staff, friends, families, good afternoon and welcome to St. Anselm College's 123rd commencement ceremony. Classmates, we first gathered here on this very green, on a sunny day, just like today, 3 years, 8 months, and 28 short days ago. But who's counting? Well, I have, I remember sitting in these very plastic chairs as Father Jonathan welcomed us to campus, thinking that I was not going to fit in here, that I was too strange, too different. I wasn't Catholic or from a private school in Massachusetts. And I had no idea what a Vineyard Vines or a Lululemon was. Little did I know that we would be met with the great equalizer of awkwardness, spelling our names with our butts. Yeah. From there on, who we were in high school didn't matter anymore. In those 3 days, it wasn't the icebreakers or running around campus in 90 minutes on the hottest day of 2012, or watching a hypnotized Brian Salvi give birth that united us as a class. No, it was when we raised that banner in Davison that we became the Saint Anselm College class of 2016. Although 1,367 days have passed, in some ways, the butterflies in our stomach never left. Just like you did during Father Jonathan's speech, some of you have already tuned out and are reflecting on the incredible memories we made here. For some, waiting 3 hours outside of Davison to be the first in line at the Christmas feast, or the excitement and the irrational stress that is the annual gingerbread building contest. For others, it may be the nights that turned into mornings with your best friends, winter and spring breaks spent losing yourself in service to others, or building up the courage to hop the fence and take a plunge in polio pit. Whatever your dearest memories may be, you did not make them alone. The same can be said of the accomplishments that led us here today. Look around you. You'll see the professor who spent countless hours working with you to understand a difficult concept or draft your thesis. Take notice of the mentors who challenged you to be the best version of yourself and inspired you to pursue your vocation. And don't overlook your friends and relatives who supported you and encouraged you when you thought today was out of your reach. All of them are beaming with pride. Some may even be crying. I know my mom is. Pull it together, Priscilla. We all should be proud of what we have overcome to be here today and be grateful for the immense support we received along the way. While there is no doubt that we are elated and sentimental, we cannot deny the fear of what tomorrow brings. Many of us, myself included, are afraid of what comes next. I'm not ready to leave the familiarity of Alumni Hall, the relationships that I have made, and what has become our home. With student loan payments steadily approaching, uncertainty in the job market, and the fear that when I say goodbye to you all, it may be forever, I worry about whether I'll be able to make it and what people have been telling us is the real world. Despite the uncertainty of the future, we will meet the challenges that arise because Saint Anselm College has been preparing us for this very day for the past 3 years, 8 months, and 28 days. Change may be what we are most afraid of, but it is also what we are most familiar with. It has been the only constant here. As we transitioned into college in our first year, the Abbey elected a new abbot for the first time in 26 years. That same year, the church elected a new pope. A year later, we witnessed the installation of the college's first lay president and toasted to another century of St. Anselm College on its 125th birthday. Additionally, we marked the end of an academic era as the college transitioned to a new core curriculum and phased out the 2-year humanities program, which we will brag for years to come that we were the last class to complete. Even though a select few of us went to every lecture or did all of the readings, humanities was the cornerstone of what it meant to be Anselmian for much longer than most of us have been alive. Consequently, I hope that you take something from the program. Whether it's a memory of when Professor Bruchard threw his note cards at us during his last lecture in the program, or perhaps the basic precepts of the rule of Saint Benedict and learning to listen with the ear of your heart. May the time we spent together in lecture and seminar bolster and inspire you in the thousands of conversations that lie in your future. Yet, the lessons that we ought to take away from Saint Anselm College are not limited to what we learned in the Dana Center. It is also important to remember when we came together as Anselmians and made history where it was being made every day. During the 100th anniversary of the first in the nation New Hampshire primary, we were on the front lines of the democratic process. The world looked to the hilltop to decide the next president of the United States. In times of tragedy, such as the Boston bombing and other numerous global acts of terror, we prayed for peace together on the steps of Joseph Hall. Moreover, we enacted change on our campus and stood up for what we believe in by protesting for social justice and the dignity of all people and relaying for life. Together, we applied what we learned in the classroom and proved that we are educated, engaged, and eager to become contributing members of society. I urge us to recall what Father Jonathan advised us here on this quad during freshman orientation 3 years, 8 months, and 28 days ago. When challenges come up, he said, and they surely will, conjure up a memory of today. Just as we have grown since August 23rd, 2012, the meaning of those words have changed. His words no longer bring us back to when everything was new and we were just learning what it meant to become an Anselmian. Nostalgia begins today. From now on, those words beacon us to remind us of this day, May 21st, 2016, the culmination of our experiences here. Regardless of current opinions regarding millennials, our Benedictine liberal arts education will always drive us to seek truth, respect all people, and strive to make a positive impact in the world. This college has given us the proper tools to be agents of change, and it is up to all of us to live up to this potential. I look forward to seeing all that you have achieved when we meet on this quad for the next time. Who knows? Maybe 3 years, 8 months, and 28 days from now. Anyway, we won't start counting until tomorrow. Today is for celebrating. Today is for gratitude. Congratulations, members of the class of 2016, and thank you for making the past 1,367 days the best days of my life so far. Thank you.
The American Association of University Professors, Saint Anselm College Chapter, presents an annual award to a member of the faculty of the college. Dr. Nicole Leapley, Associate Professor of Modern Languages and Literatures and President of the AAUP chapter on campus, will announce this year's award.
Each year, the St. Anselm College chapter of the AUP presents the Distinguished Faculty Award at graduation. It recognizes excellence in teaching and scholarship, contributions to the academic community through active and positive relations with colleagues and students, and an involved concern for humanity. Active, trusted, innovative, measured, insightful. These are some of the words faculty used in nominating this year's honoree. recognized by fellow faculty as one of the best facilitators of intellectual and academic conversations on this campus, our recipient is genuinely interested in the work of colleagues from across the campus, regardless of discipline. This outstanding mentor supports newer faculty in ways they characterize as incredibly helpful. Despite our recipient's understated style, the most senior faculty deeply value our recipient's insights and stop to listen when this person talks. Those who have attended faculty senate meetings will agree this is remarkable. After completing a doctorate at the University of Pennsylvania and a 3-year postdoc at New York University, our recipient spent 8 years teaching as an assistant and associate professor in Pennsylvania before joining the faculty here. Our recipient served both as department chair and as faculty senator early on, once at St. Anselm College. But this commitment to colleagues and to the college continues, uncurbed. Indeed, our honoree is currently serving as a senator and this year chaired the Rank and Tenure Committee, considered by many to be the most time-consuming, but also the most consequential Senate committee. After more than 25 years at St. Anselm College, our recipient remains committed to working closely with students, continuing to direct advanced research and to run special study sessions. Our recipient, of course, provides the pizza. Our recipient is recognized by students as one of the most dedicated and supportive faculty members on campus. This year's prize winner has published with students and over a long career won a number of grants, including one to improve lab instruction here at St. Anselm College. Although one of the most experienced teachers on campus, this professor never stops learning. Recently attending a workshop on teaching chemistry in the context of our planet, and another organized by the National Science Foundation on chemistry and art. This fall, our recipient team taught a brand new course on the chemistry of art with Professor Bentz of the Fine Arts Department. The St. Anselm community has been the beneficiary of the insatiable curiosity of this mind, which is always seeking to better understand the world with the help of his chosen discipline, chemistry, but also by going beyond it. I would especially like to recognize our recipient's exemplary commitment to the college. He has taught students, carried out research, and generously served the community here for 27 years. All three of his children are St. Anselm alums. This year, his little granddaughter, Claire, helped us celebrate Shakespeare's 400th birthday with a sonnet. It is people like our recipient and the devotion of their talent, work, and hard-earned expertise, their willingness to give of themselves, that makes St. Anselm College what it is. Today, I am honored to present the 2016 AAUP Award for Excellence in Faculty Accomplishment to Professor George Perotti.
At this time, I would like to ask Abbot Mark Cooper, Abbot of St. Anselm Abbey and Chancellor of the College, to present the highest award of the college, the Chancellor's Award. The Chancellor's Medal is awarded to the student with the highest grade point average of the graduating class. The top student in the class of 2016 is a biochemistry major from Londonderry, New Hampshire, with a grade point average of 3.967. The recipient of the Chancellor's Medal is Nicholas Bompastori. On this 123rd commencement of St. Anselm College, it is my pleasure to introduce Dr. Stephen DiSalvo, President of the College, who will now deliver the President's address. Ladies and gentlemen, President DiSalvo.
Before I begin my formal remarks, I would like to thank the person responsible for the weather, Father Peter Guerin. Thank you, Father Peter. Members of the class of 2016, family and friends, Abbot Mark and members of the monastic community, Madam Chair Petrini Smith and members of the Board of Trustees, members of the faculty, President Emeritus Father Jonathan D. Felice, Dr. Montrone, Sister Maxine, Mr. Pollard, and Mr. Sheehan, who we welcome back to the Hilltop to give our address. It is with great pride and joy that I welcome you to the 123rd commencement celebration and offer my personal congratulations to the class of 2016 on the completion of their academic degrees. Today, we celebrate their accomplishments and have an opportunity to reflect on the moments that have brought us all together for this very happy occasion. 4 years ago, you arrived to begin an academic journey that has prepared you well to enter the workforce or to continue your education with graduate studies. A rigorous curriculum rooted in the liberal arts has sharpened your oratory abilities, critical thinking skills, and theological foundation. This was not simply a transfer of knowledge, but rather a course from which to grow academically, socially, and spiritually. You have been led by the charge to contribute to the common good, and for that, you are uniquely Anselmian. So after a few thousand meals in Davison Hall in the coffee shop, hundreds of nights in a twin-size bed, dozens of close friendships forged, and countless memories made, today brings closure to your time as an undergraduate. There are likely many moments that you've been reflecting on in the past week to define your St. Anselm experience, from the sudden euphoria of freedom and fear of the unknown when your parents dropped you off at Dom or JOA, to the terror of realizing you didn't know how to do laundry 2 weeks later. You've celebrated game-winning moments with teammates, questioned humanity alongside fellow volunteers during service trips, and probably walked into at least one class with a question for your classmate. Did you do the reading? Each moment taught you something about being part of a community, about contributing to the common good, about being prepared. You've celebrated 4 years of homecoming and family weekend. You've probably been to at least one intense night of Cabingo, took in an Abbey Players performance, and brought a group of friends to the pub on Tuesday night for trivia, especially when Father Cecil was playing. And today, you can collectively say that you survived senior days. Sort of. Perhaps you met a presidential candidate or worked behind the scenes at one of the debates. I hope that being up close and personal with the primary process here on campus has encouraged you to be more active citizens now and in the future. There are few certainties in life, but major political figures visiting our campus is one of them. And as alumni, we hope that your pride only grows as you continue to see St. Anselm in the spotlight. Events around the globe and some events that struck too close to home have shaped you too and will impact your future as well. You will enter a world that is full of promise and a fair amount of uncertainty. In your 4 years on the Hilltop, you have lived through the incomprehensible Sandy Hook shooting and Boston Marathon bombing. Paris and Brussels were attacked, and the threat of terrorism is unfortunately still ever present. Headlines bounce around the world at the speed of a tweet. Although I learned Snapchats were in now, so. But even His Holiness Pope Francis, whose election was a very meaningful moment for many of you, has almost 10 million followers. This spring, he tweeted, "I am beginning a new journey. on Instagram to walk with you along the path of mercy and the tenderness of God. There has been much to celebrate in the past 4 years. Great strides have been made, from diplomatic breakthroughs to groundbreaking discoveries in laboratories and IPOs that continue to set records. And you once again celebrated the Patriots winning the Super Bowl. Our society will only continue to be enhanced by your talents in the years to come. You hold the keys to make our world a better place. After all, you enter it with a Saint Anselm College degree. And obtaining a Saint Anselm degree is not designed to be an easy task. Through the best of days, and particularly during the most challenging, you have had faculty, friends, and family at your side. These years would not have been the same without the support of your loved ones. They share in your joy today. Always remember to tell those around you how much you love them and thank them for their support. At the heart of our college is the Benedictine community. We honor our founders, the monks of the Order of Saint Benedict, and we continue to be grateful to their successors, the monks of Saint Anselm Abbey, for preserving our mission today and into the future, and for meeting the challenges along the way with unwavering optimism and faith. When you leave campus today, you will have turned a page on an amazing chapter in your life, and will continue to write your story in new places among new people. But I hope that no matter where your journey takes you, you know that you are always welcome home. You may be leaving the ranks of the student body, but you are now and forever entering the alumni community. While your 4 years have undoubtedly gone by all too fast, it is this final year that may have left the deepest impression. It was a year named by Pope Francis as a year of mercy. He told us, "Let us not forget that God forgives and God forgives always. Let us never tire of asking for forgiveness." He went on to say that we will find in this Jubilee year the joy to rediscover and render fruitful the mercy of God. It is through those works of mercy that we can authentically reflect on the Word of God and put those words into action. So I wish you all Godspeed in your lifelong journey. Have faith in the future, and may God guide each and every one of you today and for the rest of your lives as proud graduates of Saint Anselm College. I leave you with one final thought. College is for 4 years. Saint Anselm College is forever. Thank you, and God bless you.
On the occasion of these commencement exercises, St. Anselm College honors three individuals whose contributions to society are judged worthy of public commendation and of imitation by our departing students. Our honored guests have influenced others for the good through leadership in various fields. It is our hope that by honoring these individuals, our graduates will be inspired to imitate them in the coming years. President DiSalvo will present and read the citations.
At this time, I would ask Dr. Paul Montrone to please come forward. Paul Montrone's career spans more than three decades and includes a legacy of leadership at some of the most prestigious names in the corporate history of New Hampshire and the world. However, his significant success is recorded not only in business, but in his strong and continued commitment to public service. There are few individuals anywhere who can claim such a diverse range of experiences and accomplishments. His career began at the Pentagon, where he was a captain in the United States Army and a helicopter pilot. Paul moved on to the private sector, where he garnered major success developing corporations ranging from the Signal Companies, now Honeywell International, to Wheelabrator Technologies. Later on, as CEO of Fisher Scientific International, Paul led the company through an IPO and into a merger with Thermo Electron, where Fisher was transformed into a global concern with equity value that grew from $200 million to $12 billion. Even at the height of his remarkable corporate achievements, Paul Montrone's leadership contributions were never restricted to the private sector. Throughout his career, he has devoted himself to government service on business and healthcare policy. He was a member of President Clinton's Advisory Commission on Consumer Protection and Quality in the Healthcare Industry and founded the National Forum for Healthcare Quality Measurement and Reporting. He is currently a director of the Foundation for the National Institutes of Health. In New Hampshire, Paul was a founder of two nonprofit organizations, the Live Free or Die Alliance, which promotes citizen engagement in public policy, and the Coalition for Job Creation, an initiative that generates and improves employment opportunity. Here at St. Anselm College, he has been an instrumental partner with our New Hampshire Institute of Politics, working to engage our community with important civic activities. He has also chaired the board of St. Anselm's Ethics in Governance Program. He sits on the boards of the Metropolitan Opera of New York, one of my personal favorites, the New England Conservatory of Music, and the Boston Symphony Orchestra, as well as the Columbia University Graduate School of Business. By any standards, his career has been extraordinary, but most importantly, Paul Montrone embodies one of the fundamental principles of St. Anselm College traditions, a commitment to service and to the betterment of society in everything that he does. Abbot Mark, in recognition of his many contributions to the public and private national good, as well as his leadership and dedication to the service of diverse local, national, and global fields and communities, I am honored to present Paul M. Montrone for the degree of Doctor of Business honoris causa.
Paul Montrone, by the authority of the Board of Trustees of St. Anselm College, I confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Business honoris causa. In accordance with usual custom, you are entitled to all the rights and privileges which pertain to this degree here and elsewhere. In token thereof, we award you this diploma and invest you with the appropriate hood.
I would now ask Charles W. Pollard to please come forward. It may be said that Chuck Pollard defines the term high flyer. As a distinguished executive in the airline industry, he has helped to move passengers and cargo around the world throughout his career. However, in all of his many accomplishments, he also embodies another term, which we are very proud to call him. Anselmian. A 1979 graduate of St. Anselm, he continued his studies at Maxwell Graduate School of Syracuse University and George Washington University Law School before beginning his career as an attorney. He served in the corporate practice group of one of the world's preeminent law firms, Skadden Arps, but found his true life's work in the airline industry. In 1987, he joined World Airways, where he held various executive positions, eventually including president and chief executive officer. Chuck went on to found Omni Air International, also a passenger charter airline, growing the company from a developmental stage business and later serving a term as president and CEO. He serves on various corporate boards, including Air Partner, Allegiant Travel, and Air Castle Limited. A true Anselmian throughout his life and career, he has also devoted his considerable expertise to making the world a better place through engagement with nonprofit organizations. He served as head of the professional business team at the Tulsa Area United Way and as chairman of the Board of Trustees for the Kingsbury Center of Washington, D.C., one of the first organizations to provide diagnostic services, tutoring, and specialized day school for children with learning differences. Last, but certainly not least, for more than a decade, Chuck served his alma mater as a member and chair of the Saint Anselm College Board of Trustees, bringing his characteristic management skill, energy, and conviction to the advancement of the college. Abbott Mark, in recognition of his many achievements and professional successes, as well with gratitude for his leadership and dedication to others and to St. Anselm College, I am honored to present Charles W. Pollard for the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa.
Charles Pollard, by the authority of the Board of Trustees of St. Anselm College, I confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa. In accordance with the usual custom, you are entitled to all the rights and privileges which pertain to this degree here and elsewhere. In token thereof, we award you this diploma and invest you with the appropriate hood.
I would now ask Sister Maxine Dorothy Schneider to please come forward. Sister Maxine Schneider entered the Sisters of St. Joseph of Springfield, Massachusetts in 1960 when she was just a teenager. More than 50 years later, she is still serving the congregation in the finest spirit of their mission to live and work that all people may be united with God and with one another. A highly respected educator and academic leader at both the high school and college level, her commitment to her calling led her, as the sisters are vowed, to discover where needs are greatest and go there with love of God and love of neighbor. With three of her sisters, she founded the House of Peace and Education, better known as HOPE, which provides training for women and after-school and summer academic support for children from kindergarten through high school in Gardner, Massachusetts. Later on, she joined two other Sisters of St. Joseph at Weston Rehab Associates, teaching women who have been incarcerated to learn and practice essential skills for life and for work. She has helped so many throughout her life and career. But when Sister Maxine became president of the Sisters of St. Joseph of Springfield in 2011, she faced the new and significant challenge of helping her congregation to survive. It had become clear that their financial situation was dire and that within a few years, they would be without cash assets, with 200 aging sisters for whom to care. As head of a dedicated leadership team, she made the very difficult decision to sell the congregation's beloved Mother House property in Holyoke and move their frail elder sisters to share retirement facilities with the Boston Sisters of St. Joseph. She is currently leading a major fundraising campaign to repair the finances of the congregation in the interest of providing for their future support and continued service. A compassionate and steadfast servant leader, Sister Maxine is an inspiring example of the unity and peace that a commitment to others can bring to community everywhere. She embodies the missions of both the Sisters of St. Joseph and of St. Anselm College as an educator, a leader, and a woman of true faith. Abbot Mark, in recognition of her outstanding and faithful service, devoted work to help those in need, and her contributions to the preservation of her congregation, I am honored to present Sister Maxine Dorothy Schneider for the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa.
Sister Maxine Schneider, by the authority of the Board of Trustees of St. Anselm College, I confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa. In accordance with the usual custom, you are entitled to all the rights and privileges which pertain to this degree here and elsewhere. In token thereof, we award you this diploma and invest you with the appropriate hood.
Our commencement speaker is someone who needs almost no introduction to the St. Anselm community, or any other in New England and beyond. As Chief Executive Officer of the Boston Globe, Mike Sheehan's unmistakable stamp of quality and style is evident daily, in every living room and on every device where the paper is read. St. Anselm College may make some claim of our own contribution to Mike's remarkable career. Though he had worked at a newspaper before he even arrived on campus, serving as sports editor for the Weymouth News at the youthful age of 15, during his time on the Hilltop, the former English major was editor of the St. Anselm Crier, in addition to working for the Boston Globe, Boston Magazine, and the Quincy Patriot Ledger, all while he was still a student. His achievements since that time have been many, varied, and equally extraordinary. Before coming to the Globe, Mike spent 20 years at Hill Holliday, where he served as chairman, chief executive officer, president, and chief creative officer. In addition to Hill Holliday, Mike served as an associate creative director at Leo Burnett and was executive creative director at DDB Chicago, where he oversaw McDonald's and where he taught us "We love to make you smile." Everyone is also familiar with the slogan, "America runs with Duncan," thanks to, in large part, to the creative genius of Mike Sheehan. As impressive as his resume is, as outstanding his career, Mike has consistently dedicated the same energy and commitment that he brings to the boardroom and the newsroom to the service of others in his community. He served for nearly a decade with distinction as a member and chair of St. Anselm's Board of Trustees, advocating vigorously for the college's continuous advancement and contributing generously in every way to that goal. He also worked tirelessly in the aftermath of the Boston Marathon bombing to help establish One Fund Boston and served on the board of the Catholic Charities of the Archdiocese of Boston. Mike Sheehan embodies the very best qualities of Anselmians everywhere. On May 21st, 2011, on the 29th anniversary of his graduation, Saint Anselm College presented Mike with an honorary degree of Doctor of Laws. With gratitude for his many contributions to the progress of Saint Anselm College and in recognition of his creative talent and professional success. As he comes forward to address the class of 2016, please join me in giving a very warm welcome home to Mike Sheehan.
Don't mind if I take my hat off. I have a beautiful dye job that I want you all to notice and appreciate. Abbot Mark and members of the monastic community, President DiSalvo, trustees of the college, administrators, distinguished faculty, honorary degree recipients, families, friends, and most of all, members of the class of 2016, it is my sincere honor to be chosen as your commencement speaker. Before I even get started, I'd like to ask the class of 2016 for a standing ovation. Not for me, but for the parents of the class of the 2016. You have no idea the significant sacrifices they've made to get you to this day. That was very nice, and now maybe Mom and Dad won't mind so much when you move back in with them. What a glorious few days God has given us. The senior days, the honors convocation, baccalaureate mass, and now commencement. Blue skies for the whole week, mid-70s, and now a little cloud cover to keep my dermatologist happy. I have to give it all a solid C+. Because even God can't get an A at St. Anselm College. But do not worry. If there's one truism I've learned in 30 plus years in business, it's this. The A students work for the B students, whose companies eventually get acquired by the C students. I'd really like to begin by introducing my family, upon whose unconditional support I depend every single day. I'd really like to, but I can't because they didn't come. This is the fifth commencement address I've given, yet they still refuse to believe that any institution of higher learning would actually invite me to speak. Actually, I do have a family member here today, my cousin Johnny Norton, who's a member of the class of 2018. I came up to campus for the Republican debate in early February, so I figured I'd ask Johnny if he wanted to meet for dinner. I got to campus around 5 in the evening, and I called Johnny on his cell. Of course, I had to apologize for waking him up at that early hour, but he hopped out of bed and met me at the coffee shop. I shared with him the exciting news that I had just been asked to be this year's commencement speaker. Really, he asked. Well, who else is speaking? Sorry, Johnny, life isn't fair, I'm all you got. I came to St. Anselm College as a student in as haphazard a manner as there possibly is. I had already attended two colleges, the United States Naval Academy and Northeastern University, and I was working nights in the library of the Boston Globe when a friend of mine, who was a senior in high school at the time, asked me if I wanted to come along with him on one of his campus visits. It was to a college in New Hampshire I had never heard of, named after a saint I had never prayed to. My friend went on a campus tour, and I hung out in the waiting room of the admissions office. You can imagine the magazines I had to choose from. Catholic Digest, Magnificat, Christus Veritas. Seriously, I was looking for the deep, meaningful stuff, the Rolling Stone, People, Sports Illustrated bathing suit issue. I got so bored, I filled out an application. When the letter of acceptance arrived a few weeks later, I said, hey, why not? And I came up that fall as a sophomore transfer. I don't think you could find another alumnus who arrived here on day one with a greater sense of ambivalence or dispassion. St. Anselm College? Hey, why not? In the 37 years since then, I think it's fairly apparent that the college grew on me. But it wasn't until very recently that I really understood what makes this place and these people so special. And it's not like I didn't try. Differentiating brands and communicating that difference is what I did as an advertising creative for 30 years. I could do it for some of the largest brands in the world, but as a student, an alumnus, and a trustee, I could never quite put a finger on what exactly defined this institution. I can't tell you the number of times I've explained, well, it's a Benedictine college run by Benedictine monks, which invariably leads to the same question, well, what's a Benedictine? That's easy to explain. A Benedictine is kind of like a Jesuit, only with humility. Given the fact that since 1972, I'm only the fourth St. Anselm alumnus to address a graduating class at commencement, I think it's appropriate to share a couple of personal experiences from the past few years that helped me finally and very clearly understand what it means to be an Anselmian. When the bombs went off along the finish line of the Boston Marathon 3 years ago, I felt the same way most of you did, shocked, saddened, and deeply offended that someone, anyone, could commit such an act of pure evil. That evening, I called a friend of mine who was heading up marketing at John Hancock, who was a primary sponsor of the marathon, and offered to help in any way I could. He asked me to join in a conference call at 10 the next morning. On the call was Jim Gallagher, John Hancock's chief administrative officer, and he had just gotten off the phone with Boston Mayor Tom Menino. Mayor Menino had told him that he wanted to establish a fund to aid survivors and that he wanted it up and running by 5 p.m. that day, because that's what he had scheduled a press conference to announce the fund's formation. Over the course of 7 hours, I worked with a very small number of colleagues and associates to name the fund, One Fund Boston, create a logo, buy a domain name, set up online payment protocols, work with outside counsel to trademark and incorporate, and make sure it actually worked. When Mayor Menino stepped to the podium at 5 p.m., I'd be lying if I said we were confident that we had pulled it off, but we had. I remember a conversation with Jim Gallagher that afternoon about expectations of how much money we might be able to raise. We agreed that we just might be able to raise $10 million. That was Tuesday. We raised $10 million by Thursday. 90 days later, One Fund Boston distributed $61 million to the families of the deceased and the survivors. And by the time we dissolved the organization last December, we had distributed a total of $81 million, making it the single largest privately funded survivor relief effort in U.S. history. What made it so exceptional is that we never asked anyone for a dime. This was as simple and pure an outpouring of love and compassion as you will ever find from 200,000 people from 80 countries. I have a One Fund t-shirt framed on my office wall. A few weeks ago, a visitor noticed it. Without really thinking, I pointed at it and said, that was the single most important thing I've done in my life. Because I saw firsthand how that volunteer effort helped survivors heal. No amount of money will ever replace what was lost that April 15th, but it most certainly helped ease whatever financial burdens the survivors may have had so they could focus on the healing process. And for me, serving other people, more specifically helping people heal, is what it means to be an Anselmian. In June of 2012, I received the phone call that I had spent most of my life dreading. It was my mother telling me that my father's MRI revealed a brain tumor. My dad was 88 years old at the time, but he didn't look or act like it. Just a few weeks earlier, I had pitched batting practice to him, and you have to picture this. He was wearing Adidas cleats, and he swung a personalized bat, wooden of course. I threw him a bucket of rolling balls, and every single one of them, at the age of 88, he hit into the outfield of a regulation baseball diamond. And so it was shortly after getting that call that my dad had brain surgery at Massachusetts General Hospital. He was the recipient of the Purple Heart and the Bronze Star in World War II, and I had never seen him scared in his life until now. My sister and I took turns spending nights with him in the neurosurgery unit ICU at Mass General, sleeping in a chair next to him. It was at that point when the alarms are the loudest, the sky is the darkest, the hours are the longest, and patients are the most vulnerable that I really learned what makes this college, Saint Anselm, different from any other. Let me be clear, every nurse who attended to my father was a highly competent superstar. But every so often, I would encounter a nurse who treated my father not just as a patient, but as if he were her father. There was a sense of profound empathy, sensitivity, and optimism that I could feel far better than I can articulate. But it was as real as anything I've ever felt. Competency and compassion, kindness and charisma, in scrubs and clogs. And when I would say, if you don't mind me asking, where did you go to nursing school? The answer was invariably St. Anselm. Any college can and should prepare you to go out and be passionate about pursuing a successful career. But there are precious few schools that prepare you to be compassionate as well. St. Anselm most definitely is one of them. It doesn't matter what career you choose to pursue. It may be nursing. It may be investment banking. It could be politics or communications, accounting or education. It may be criminal justice or sociology. Regardless, you will meet people who are weak and vulnerable. They may be standing in front of you, or you may have to pull your face out of your smartphone every so often and look to the right and to the left. But they are there, their friends and neighbors, even strangers, who are suffering from addiction, abuse, poverty, physical or mental illness. And you have a choice. Will you ignore them and hurt them, or will you help them and heal them? You are an Anselmian, and like those St. Anselm alums who, with great compassion, comforted my father at Mass General at 2 and 3 in the morning, I know you'll nurture and heal them. I've asked President DiSalvo and Brother Isaac to shake things up a bit this year, and for the first time in the college's history, the nursing majors will march first. And I ask every member of the class of 2016 to follow them, literally and figuratively, in the Anselmian tradition of service, kindness, and compassion. Go be great, and be happy, and be proud. And no matter what career path you happen to choose, when you come across someone who needs healing, be a nurse. Thank you, and God bless you.
I would now like to call upon Dr. Mark Cronin, Dean of the College, for the awarding of the degrees to the graduates.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment when St. Anselm College and the wider academic community recognize the academic accomplishments of these graduates with the conferral of degrees. The degree which they will possess is a public recognition that they have engaged in the labor which is learning, experienced the joy which is discovery, and now possess the achievement which is knowledge. Will the graduates please rise? President DiSalvo, it is my pleasure to present to you the candidates for the degrees of Honors Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Science, Honors Bachelor of Arts, and Bachelor of Arts. The faculty of St. Anselm College have guided them through the prescribed course of studies in the arts and sciences, have examined them on their worthiness, and certify that they are indeed worthy to receive these degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of St. Anselm College and the State of New Hampshire, I confer the degree of Honors Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Science, Honors Bachelor of Arts, and Honors Bachelor of Arts with all the rights, honors, and privileges pertaining to these degrees here and elsewhere on those now presented by the Dean of the College. Congratulations.
And please be seated. Dear graduates, it is now the moment you have waited for and worked for. Ladies and gentlemen, you are about to hear that one special name. For the sake of grandparents and parents, friends and family, who want nothing more than to hear their one special name, I request on behalf of the graduates that until all of the degrees have been conferred by the president of the college, that you withhold your applause and other expressions of joy and utter disbelief. The honors, Bachelor of Science, Beth Ann Westgate, summa cum laude. The Bachelor of Science, Alexandra Christina Anton, cum laude. Alexandra Mary Bamford, cum laude. Maria Elena Bazzano, cum laude. Sarah Diane Bolio, cum laude. Ashley Lynn Blades, magna cum laude. Taylor M. Blaine, cum laude. Jenna Daniel Bossi. Mary Lorraine Boyer, cum laude. Colleen Megan Boyle, cum laude. Ashley Elizabeth Bradley. Yeah! Abigail Mary Brigham. Linglan Chen, summa cum laude. Brooke Marie Cormier. Yeah, Hannah Margaret Correa. Amber Sean Culwell, magna cum laude. Bridget Patricia Davis. Kaylee Mary Ellen Day, cum laude. Catherine Marie DiBenedetto. Caitlin Erin Delaney, cum laude. Jacqueline Ann DeMeo, summa cum laude. Elena Victoria DeMello, cum laude. Tierney Rebecca Dennehy. Danielle Marie DeBias. Colleen Elizabeth Duffy. Erin Bailey Duggan, cum laude. Allison Marie Dwan. Mary Caitlin Fisher. Leah C. Fitzgerald, magna cum laude. Michaela Catherine Foley. Rachel Marie Follett. Katie O'Brien Gargano, magna cum laude. Rachel Lynn Gillies, cum laude. Jessica Rose Gibson, cum laude. Desiree Elizabeth Guaraldi, magna cum laude. Megan Lynn Halligan, magna cum laude. Ashley Ames Hart, summa cum laude. Emily Helen Hartnett. Aubrey Teresa Herr. Allison Kathleen Higgins. Samantha Noreen Hogan, summa cum laude. Jillian Angeli Holmes, cum laude. Lindsay Ann Iadarola. Melissa Ann Jackson, magna cum laude. Emily Grace Johnson, cum laude. Nicole Jutris. Amanda Rose Lalim, magna cum laude. Samantha Ruth Lamb, cum laude. Miriam Ann Lautenschlager, cum laude. Bianca Rose Mancini. Kristen Rose Marino. Jessica Page Massey, cum laude. Emily Rose Maddie. Robin Lynn McClelland, cum laude. Kristen Ann McKay, summa cum laude. Felicia Rebecca McKinnon, magna cum laude. Amy Marie Moynihan, cum laude. Jenna Harriet Osborne, summa cum laude. Ashlyn Wright Parkhurst, cum laude. Nicole Kyla Pellegrini. Chelsea C. Persibale, magna cum laude. Lindsay Catherine Petris, cum laude. Warren Joseph Phillips III, cum laude. Emma Caitlin Powowski, cum laude. Marissa Jewel Rainville. Sarah Ann Reed, cum laude. Megan Lynn Rich. Jessica Laura Sanderson, cum laude. Catherine Victoria Schmadel. Kimberly Ann Schubert. Morgan Elizabeth Shari, cum laude. Sarah Margaret St. Ong, magna cum laude. Megan Elizabeth Sullivan. Brittany Lynn Taylor. Amanda Margaret Tiki. Maria Cherry Turner, cum laude. Jessica Marie Wiggin, magna cum laude. Abigail Diane Winterstein, cum laude. The Honors, Bachelor of Arts. Christine Emily Adams, summa cum laude. Abdulaziz Mohammed Al-Shar Arwi, summa cum laude. Lindsay Ray Bishop. Nicholas Joseph Bompastori, summa cum laude. Vanessa Nicole Burton, cum laude. Zachary Scott Kamenker, cum laude. Michelle Marie Conte, summa cum laude. Michaela Maud Criscione, summa cum laude. Charles Joseph Dooley III, summa cum laude. Kelsey Reagan Fair, magna cum laude. Hannah Elizabeth Gallucci, cum laude. Alicia Erin Griffin, cum laude. Raquel Judith Johnson. Jamie Barbara Kender, magna cum laude. Mariana Kale Aloha o Kalahui Ava Iloaha Kaimi Na Uau Oke Ayao Ayao Christensen. Few. Carrie Ann Licata Marino, magna cum laude. Charles James Moriarty, cum laude. Ian Robert Norton, cum laude. Austin Lawrence O'Connor, cum laude. Tyler John Pare, magna cum laude. Matthew Kirk Rochelo, summa cum laude. Nicole Marie Rugen, cum laude. Elizabeth Kelsey Sawyer, cum laude. Alicia Marie Sorrell, cum laude. Marie Felicita Turner, summa cum laude. Kristen Elizabeth Van Uden, summa cum laude. Nolan Ewing Vare. Corey Gerald Vicera, cum laude. The Bachelor of Arts, Emily Catherine Abert. Alyssa Torje Altimus, cum laude. Christopher John Anderson, cum laude. Fraser Catherine Aretz. Joanne Paula Armstrong, cum laude. Alexandra Mary Ashburn, cum laude. Olivia Kathleen Ashburn. Jessica Beverly Avalar. Caitlin Mary Avril. Paige Elizabeth Baronis, cum laude. Emily Rose Barrett, cum laude. India Colas Barros. Sarah Jessica Bartlett. Ryan Douglas Beal, summa cum laude. Caroline Grace Bomier. Caitlin McPartland Beaumont, summa cum laude. Kira Helene Berge, cum laude. Nicole Mary Biondo. Emily Margaret Bogosian. Amanda Coulter Borisovich, cum laude. Kyle Dennis Boucher. Kevin James Bugulis, magna cum laude. Jeffrey Sean Boyle, cum laude, commissioned this morning as a U.S. Marine. Allison Elizabeth Bracey, cum laude. James Thomas Brennan, magna cum laude. Timothy Robert Brogan. Tyler Edward Buck. Tara Marie Buckley, cum laude. Lauren Marie Bukeji. Jane Elizabeth Bunn. Brianna Brady Butts. Alexander Michael Buxbaum. Joseph Anthony Cahill, cum laude. Emily Margaret Callahan, cum laude. Laura Jean Canole. Brianna Ashley Capistrand, summa cum laude. Joshua Michael Capraro. Samantha Joe Marie Cardoso. Brian Mary Constance Carroll. Brendan John Cathcart. Brianna Nicole Charette. Anthony Philip Champy, summa cum laude. Kimberly Ann Salento, magna cum laude. Amy Margaret Clancy, cum laude. Megan Kelly Clifford. Mackenzie William Collins. Patrick Cahill Conley. Taylor Madeline Coons. Catherine Ann Corbett, cum laude. Paul Francis Corcoran. Christina Luella Coronis, cum laude. Alad Kalvalyu. Emily Rose Crennell. Patrick John Craven, magna cum laude. Robert Michael Craig Jr., cum laude. Kristen Crowley. Sarah Margaret Cummings. William Francis Curley III. Shannon M. Curtin. Jonathan Michael Daniels. Philip Louise Rodriguez Davis. Rochelle Dooley Davis. Edmund Seaman Dawes III, summa cum laude. Jacqueline Suzanne DiColligero. Alex Stephen DeFranzo, magna cum laude. Mary Patricia Devine, cum laude. Nicholas Vincent Di Benedetto, magna cum laude. Sung Huang Do, magna cum laude. Jessica Abigail Doe, cum laude. Robert Sean Dombrowski. Colleen McLaughlin Donahue, cum laude. Tam Sai Dong. Enda James Dunbar. Christopher Thomas Duquette. Kathleen Mary Duquette. Taylor Marie Eels, cum laude. Karen Obiageli Ejiofor. Derek Raymond Elwell. William Patrick Endicott, cum laude. Emily Grace Erickson, cum laude. Tyler Curtis Esty. Sophia Grace Fabrizio, cum laude. Sabrina Celine Fahey, cum laude. Eugenia Valentina Fandunyan, cum laude. Thomas Andrew Fanekos. Jennifer Ann Farah, summa cum laude. Marisa Anella Fejo. Sean Michael Fitzgerald. Colin Walter Flynn. Mackenzie Michael Flynn. Sean Michael Foley Jr. Zachary Raymond Fortin. Devin Teresa Galante, cum laude. Jessica Rose Galicheski, magna cum laude. Alexandra Marie Galley, magna cum laude. Sarah Marie Geisinger. Felicia Marie Giannetti. Elizabeth Catherine Gilboy. Brianna Lee Goddard, summa cum laude. Vanessa Tara Goddard. Stephen Maynard Gonya. Jessica Lee Goucher, magna cum laude. Nina Sherry Ghazi. Renee N. Gramolini, magna cum laude. Shane Allen Grayson. Zachary William Green, magna cum laude. Andrew Joseph Grenier. Christopher William Griebel. Natalie Viola Gilmet. Felicia Brittany Haggerty. Shannon Elaine Haggerty, summa cum laude. Jessica Kathleen Halliday. Jacob Matthew Hamill. Stephen Michael Hamilton, summa cum laude. Daniel Vincent Hanley. Ryan Joseph Hartung, magna cum laude. Megan Claire Hazeltine. Derek Logan Herr. Haley Morgan Heinrich. Brendan John Heldorfer. Shannon Morgan Hess, summa cum laude. Smriti Hoda, cum laude. Channing Kavanaugh Hodgkins, cum laude. Kelly Ann Hoppler, cum laude. Emily Sarah Houle. Jennifer Susan Hoyt, cum laude. Tatiana Hoyt, magna cum laude. Griffin Michael Ingenito. Gregory Eric Insana. Stephen Michael Iodice. Ashley Elizabeth Ireland, magna cum laude. Talia Victoria Gillette. Michael Arman Janjigian. Lisa Maciel Jimenez. Brandon Lee Johnson. Joel Nathaniel Jorgensen. Victor Joshua. John Joseph Joyce. Ryan James Kahn. Liliana Kane, cum laude. Jessica Ann Caton, cum laude. Brandon Robert Kavanaugh. Alexandra Mary Kasmer, magna cum laude. Erin Caroline Keefe. Gregory Paul Keegan. Christopher John Kelleher.
Yes, ma'am.
Jacqueline Ann Kelly, cum laude. Hallie Tilson Kent, cum laude. Brendan Michael Keown. Colin Patrick Kelly, Kylie. Samantha Rose Kylie, cum laude. Taylor Marie Kirby. Laya Rose Kolb. Michelle Marie Cudlate, cum laude. Nicole Christine Legacy. Marissa Elizabeth Lally. Kayla Susan Lanigan, magna cum laude. Lyndon P. Langthorne. Kelsey Ann Latcha, cum laude. Rosemary Teresa Lozier, magna cum laude. Elena Marie Levine. Julie Ann LeClaire. Timothy John Lehman. Kyle Martin Lefebvre. Catherine Mary Ledger. Alexander Raymond LeMay. Meredith Ellen Leonard. Kelly Ann Laziska, cum laude. Taylor Austin Levy. Tyler Gideon Lindsay. Servando Andreas Yanio Jr. Michael Larry Lombard. Sarah Elizabeth McCauley. Alec John McDougall. Kristen Amy McCray. Benjamin Boynton Mack. Kenneth Peter Makowitz, magna cum laude. Christopher David Madden, magna cum laude. Colin John Mahoney. Yeah, Colin. Kenneth Perry Mayu, summa cum laude. Christina Marie Maloney, summa cum laude. Alexis Nicole Marathis. Ashley Marie Marchand. Nicholas William Marino, cum laude. Erin Maureen Marshall. Molly Christina Abbott Marshall. Daniel Francisco Martorelli. Anna Francis Maziars, cum laude. Jared Scott McAdam. Michael Christopher McKehee. Julia Hope McClure, magna cum laude. James Matthew McCurdy, cum laude. Hannah Marie McGowan. Catherine Norris McKenna, summa cum laude. Cameron Dwayne McLevage. Megan Ann McNamara. Alan John Macquarie III, magna cum laude. Mark Anthony Meads. Callie Rose Millett. Jordan Taylor Mitchell. Whitney Marie Moreau. Rachel Alexandra Morell. Jake Andrew Morley. Charles Francis Morris III. Sean Edward Morris. Kenneth David Morosino Jr. Catherine Marie Morse. Colleen Rose Mulcahy. Rebecca Chessie Mullen. Andrew Thomas Murphy. Scott Patrick Murphy, cum laude. Thomas Andrew Murphy, cum laude. Cody Robert Murray. Anna Nguyen, cum laude. Long Zui Nguyen, magna cum laude. Nancy Yem Yen, cum laude. Kayla Catherine Nice, cum laude. Lindsay Ann Nisovich, cum laude. Brendan Andrew Nichols. Alvin Earl Nix III. Ryan Maxwell Noble, magna cum laude. Valerie Marie Nugent, cum laude. Peter William O'Connell, cum laude. Brian Richard O'Connor. Robert Gerard O'Donnell III, cum laude. Hannah Marie O'Halloran. Kelly Louise O'Neill, cum laude. James Robert O'Neill. Brendan Matthew O'Reilly, cum laude. Neil James O'Rourke. Thomas Daniel Owens. Lauren Elizabeth Oxley. Erica Lena Pecanlis, magna cum laude. Destiny Amelia Palace, cum laude. Kayla Marie Papazian. Samuel John Paul, magna cum laude. Daniel Carlo Peltier, cum laude. Alyssa Marie Perry. Lauren Elaine Perry, cum laude. Madeline Elizabeth Peters, cum laude. Jennifer Marie Peterson, magna cum laude. Nicholas John Petromelis. Callie Claire Piacenti. Brian Matthew Pickowitz. Webster M. Pierce. Daniel Robert Pearson. Joseph Carmen Pisano, magna cum laude. Emily Therese Plud, cum laude. Matthew David Podell. Stephen Michael Pulaski III. Catherine Michelle Pombrio. Hilberto Enrique Ponza. Joshua Thomas Post. Caitlin Elizabeth Preble, magna cum laude. Matthew S. Prunk. Brianna Therese Pudlow, cum laude. Monica Lee Pustari. Rosetta Ami Quashi. Mary Elizabeth Regan. Madeline Hayward Reynolds. Katie Marie Richardson. Mary Patricia Richardson. Mackenzie Lee Richter. Catherine Elizabeth Rindo. Logan Matthew Ripa. Andrew Thomas Robbins. Luke Harold Robbins, cum laude. Michelle Kathleen Robinson. Richard Anthony Rodriguez, cum laude. Julie Clary Ronstock. Dalton James Raleigh. Alexander Michael Ross. Joseph Patrick Royal. Evan Thomas Rushton, cum laude. Courtney Marie Russell. Brian Anthony Salve, summa cum laude. Aaron Michael Sozier. Risa Catherine Sayers. Michael William Schiavi. Audrey Alexandra Schmidt, cum laude. Colleen Marie Sears, cum laude. Shannon Leslie Scholds, cum laude. Bridget Conway Sicca, cum laude. Jake William Smith. Melanie Ann Smith. Sean Robert Smith, cum laude. James Joseph Solare. Krista Michelle Sorabella. Andrew Duncan Sparks, cum laude. Patrick Anthony Spiro. Gregory Paul Spicer, cum laude. Nancy Marie Stabline, cum laude. Catherine Ann Stack. Paul Joseph Stack, Jr. Canada Ernesto Stewart, magna cum laude. Jake Taylor Stokes, magna cum laude. Thomas James Sulia. Brian Francis Sullivan. Ryan Cooper Sullivan. Sierra Beth Swords, summa cum laude. Sierra Jean Talbot, cum laude. Michael Ann Tatro. Mercedes Elizabeth Thayer, magna cum laude. Ian Peter Terrio, cum laude. Julia Lise Therian. Daniel Edward Tomasi. Kayla Marie Toner. Paul Christopher Tribuco. Alana Margaret Tremblay. Edward James Trzynski. Patricia Beau Turner, cum laude. Matthew Christopher Valonis. Caitlin Ann Villarreal, magna cum laude. Brendan Patrick Walsh. Catherine Elizabeth Walsh. Terrence Michael Walsh. Benjamin Roy Warren. Samantha Marilyn Webb, cum laude. Clayton Gregory Welch, cum laude. Jalen Joseph West Roberts. Zachary Manchester Wheeler. Meredith Ann Whitney, magna cum laude. Mackenzie Ray Wild, magna cum laude. Akeen Francis Williams. Brianna Kayla Williams. Alexandra Nicole Williamson, cum laude. Timothy Joseph Zawalek. As a symbol of your transition from student to graduate, you may now move your tassel from the right side to the left. Congratulations to the class of 2016.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand as I call upon the Right Reverend Matthew Levy, Abbot Emeritus, to conclude this commencement by invoking God's blessing upon us. Following the benediction, please remain standing for the singing of the Saint Anselm College anthem.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Heavenly Father, giver of all good gifts, it is with tremendous gratitude that we come before you today, for we believe that our very being and our very being here right now is only because of your providential love and care for us. We ask you to pour out your blessings upon the members of this graduating class today and every day of their lives. May the seeds of knowledge and truth, of wisdom and goodness planted here bear abundant fruit in the years to come. May their faith continue to seek understanding, and their understanding in turn nourish their faith. Reveal to them your will for their lives, and grant them the courage and compassion to accomplish what you ask. May they always remember that you are ever present to them at all times, but especially in time of need. May they experience your infinite love for them and be generous in showing mercy to others. All this we ask for the glory of your name, the spread of your kingdom, and the common good of all people. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you all and remain with you forever. Amen. God bless you all.
Thank you. Thank you.